What's up, guys? Today I'm going to be showing you a little replay of mine where I played Templar Assassin. One of the people that saw my rune video saw that I was playing Templar Assassin. They saw that I knew how to play it, I guess, or they thought I knew how to play it. So they asked if I can get a replay, and I said sure. And so that's what it's going to be today. It's going to be me playing Templar Assassin. A few things here and there I'll show you. Some teamfight decisions I make, and laning decisions, stuff like that. So hopefully it'll be helpful or just entertaining to watch. And yeah, so I haven't played Templar Assassin in, how long has it been? Probably a good month or so. There was a point where all I did was play Templar Assassin. I think it was like a good week. What I normally do, I don't know if you guys do this as well, but whenever I watch pro games or I see other people play or something, I see a hero and I'm like, wow, that looks really fun. And so I just go play it for like a week. And so that's how it's been for me. Right now it's Keeper of the Light. Keeper of the Light's really fun for me right now. I've been playing him pretty much constantly. But this is not part of my Templar Assassin week, but there was a point where like I really literally had like 20 games in a row to Templar Assassin. So she's a fun hero. And even after the nerfs, the trap nerf, if you didn't know, makes her initial traps 30% and you have to wait for it to go to 50% or so. And they increase the mana cost of her refraction by 25, so it's 100 instead of 75. Even after that, I think she's a great hero. Now I think she's actually balanced, because before with those other things, I think she was actually imbalanced. Because, I mean, refraction is not really the big deal. The 25 mana, yeah, it's going to limit her laning a little bit. But really, if you're a good Templar, it's not really a big deal. The biggest deal was the traps. Denied. And I thought it was a smart nerf, what Icefrog did, to still have it be the same slow, but just vary the way you have to play with it. So I thought that was good. But as I was saying, I played this girl for like a week straight, and then I already messed up the skill order because I'm noob. What you should be doing is getting one in your range at level 2 so you can actually have some range and not a freaking melee hero. And so you also have the splash. And when you do that, it's pretty much just good. Because one, you can control your lane. Two, you can just harass the other hero. And that's pretty much why you want to have it. The range, hero control, and lane control. Especially against the Shadow Fiend. He's going to have a bunch of damage. He's going to have a bunch of control with his raises. A bunch of AoE so he can just clear camps whenever he wants. You're really going to need that. And so that's my mistake. And I'll pay for it a little bit later. But it's not really a huge deal. The Shadow Fiend didn't capitalize on it so much as he could have, really. He could have just really owned me at that point. But so, there I could have bottle crowed, but we don't have a flying courier, so I figured I might as well just wait for the 4-minute rune. I have a better chance of getting that than anything. So here with the illusion rune, it's going to be really hard for me. I don't have mana because of no bottle. No flying courier yet. That was pure luck because I really didn't see him coming. But I don't think it would really matter because they wouldn't be able to kill me right then. By the time I was able to get away, I would have had like a refraction, probably on like the last hit or so. So that's not really a big deal, but that was still lucky, and that's still bad on my part that I didn't even know that he was coming. But it really did look like it, right? Because I dodged it at the last second, so it's pretty cool. So if you haven't noticed, our lanes are really weird. We have a solo disruptor against Undying and Jakiro. We have Ursa in the jungle. We have a Beastmaster also in the jungle. He is stacking Ancients. And we have Alina solo versus their Alchemist that's top, their Nature's Prophet that's jungling. Shadow Fiend is mid, obviously, and yeah. So, it's not interesting so far. It's going to pick up soon. I am able to get this haste rune right now. Luckily, Shadow Fiend never went for it. He was never able to control the creep good enough. And here I see it's an easy opportunity because Jakiro's top. I see it on the minimap chasing Lina. And so I'm like, let's just go for the kill. There's no way he can get out. Even if he didn't get trapped right here, like, it wouldn't matter because I have haste. So This is the easy first blood. As you can see in the top, there's so much icons just chasing the Lina. And I know that he's gonna die. So I'm gonna look up there in about like 2 seconds, seeing how he's still able to live. Because they've been chasing him for like a good like 30 seconds. So yeah, but he's up there and he's gonna die to the Shadow Fiend, I believe. But that still gives me time to farm. Lina dying is not such a big deal, it's normally a support anyways. She just needs like the level 7 and then it's good. She doesn't really need any items. So yeah, she went all the way to base, to their base, wasted all of their time for like four or five people's time. And so that gave me time to farm, that gave me time to put up my traps, and it's all good actually. It's actually a very worthy death because they just gave us so much time. And I was thinking I want to dive this guy so bad, but I didn't have a rune. If I had any rune, even if it was like illusion, something worthless, then I would have dived that guy. But I'm going to get this rune right now. And as you'll see, it's regeneration. I put my trap down, so I always have wards up. That's one thing you want to do when you're a Templar Assassin. One of the best things about Templar Assassin mid is the fact that you don't actually have to rely on your teammates. Because normally you have to rely on them when you're mid for wards, so you can see where the rune is, so you can control it. Templar, once you get 6, you have your own wards. So it's not really a huge deal. So here, you're going to see me royally fuck up. So I go on this guy, and I don't attack right there, which is my biggest mistake. I would have killed this guy if it wasn't for that. So here, I mess up. He has the wards. I didn't use a bottle here. And I die. But he has like 12 HP. So I messed up twice there. I could have hit him again, but I was stuttering in the very beginning. And I didn't use a bottle during the transition over to him. I would have lived with like a good 30 HP or so. And I would have got my refraction up. So I would have survived the tower hits. But whatever, it's okay. So it's not a big deal. He gets a lucky last hit. I say lucky, but I messed up. But he gets that last hit. So now I'm a little worried, but I'm not really so worried. Because I know we can just kill Shadow Fiend. If he doesn't go BKB first this game, then he's just gonna get absolutely wrecked. So I know most pub players aren't gonna do that anyways, so it's not really a huge deal. So I go, Beastmaster is still farming his jungles. He had decent farm. I remember seeing the treads and the soaring, so it's not so bad. Lina's doing fairly well. I'm pretty sure the Alchemist is free farming basically, but it's not a big deal. The Furion and Undying and Jakira are always moving around. That one thing though is that the Disruptor is always getting solo experience, and which is a very rare thing. And here's another team fight. They freeze both of us. I remember thinking I should always just go for this guy because the Undying is not gonna die, right? So I go for the Jakira. He goes for the Undying. Sadly, we split up our damage and he dies. So he blames me later that I should have went for the Undying, but I didn't really see him as such a big problem, really. Especially since the Tombstone is up and stuff like that. He's not going to die, and it's just not going to be worth their time. I think we would have both died if I didn't go for that Jakira there. But that Furion gets greedy, he stays up, he sprouts me in with him, so he's going to die. So that's quite good. I have 3 kills right now. My CS is complete shit. It's like 30, and it should be around like 45 or so right now. Excuse me. It should be about 45 or so right now. But I'm a terrible person, so I didn't really get it. Radiant's bottom tower ain't a pretty sight right now. So Alchemist, I check his items. Something you should always be doing when you're playing a hero. Check their items. A lot of people are complain when they come from League and stuff that, oh, why don't you have mana bars on your opponent, or why can't you just check their items? Well, that's the point of clicking on them, right? You see their mana and you see their items as well. So Lina dies again. It's not a big deal because Beastmaster and Disruptor are getting XP. Ursa's free farming. I'm getting free farm, and we're gonna take bottom and mid tower while they take top. So it's a fair trade, really. If you know you can't defend, like if we were all to the TP up there and defend, we wouldn't be able to because of how much like brute force they have. with the treants and all that stuff, we wouldn't be able to break it. So whenever you're gonna lose a tower and you know you can't defend it, just go get other shit. So like as you can see, I took the mid tower to half, and they're gonna take bottom tower, I believe, or even just hurt it. It's fine. So that's a very good trade in my opinion. So I get my invis. I'm like, let's go kill somebody. I'm trying to see. I really wanted the Nevermore to be here, because he would have been a very easy target. But I would say, let's go kill this guy. And Lena's like, okay. I was waiting for him to stun, but I guess they had. I guess he just wanted to leave or something, so he missed the stun. That's not very good. I dodged the ice path initially, but I still get caught in it. And I believe we get the Chikiro here, and then we get out. Yeah, we do. So now that's 4 kills. Lena's gonna die again, of course. This is not having a good amount of luck. Luckily, I put that trap down earlier before, so they can't kill me. And yeah, so I'm gonna bottle up here. I already bought my blink because I know I might die, and so I buy my TP and I get out. So if the Undying actually did his drain thing, his decay or whatever, yeah, he had mana, so I should have died there, but whatever, his loss. So now I have my blink dagger, 11 minutes 30 seconds around ish. It's not bad. You want to have it around 10. That's my personal like benchmark for playing a good TA. You have your phase boots, bottle, and blink dagger around 10, and which means my blink dagger is actually technically worse, because I already started with my bottle because I had random gold. So that's not very good of me, but oh well. It's still an early blink dagger, and if they're not paying attention, they will die. So I'm just gonna do some rats on this guy. I know I can't kill him, but I'll be able to draw him back. And it doesn't really matter to me because I have so much bottle charges that I could just refill it anyways. So I see that they're going on Roshan. I go to help out. I know we could take this, even though he has double damage, I know we could fight. So I go in, I don't care. If people are gonna follow, they're gonna follow, but I know we could win this very easily. So Jikiro keeps trying to juke his ice path, I guess, but it didn't really work. And the spacing with Disruptor, with his little gate thing, that was very good. The Thunderdome, I like to call it. So none of them can really engage when I was going on the Jikiro, and so we were able to clean that up very quickly. So when you're picking targets in fights like that, for Templar Assassin at least, you want to just pick whoever you know you can just kill instantly, and who has like a decent amount of influence on the fight. Like, let's say if it was Nature's Prophet and Jikiro in the same area, I would pick the Jikiro because Nature's Prophet, he does his ultimate and he does his sprout. Big deal. Jikiro, you have Ice Path, which is really annoying, and the Dual Breath. So that's like a very, even though he's not super high priority, like if the Shadow Fiend or Alchemist was there, I'd burst them down. But he is quite a high priority, and since they were locked down, you go for him. And he really couldn't do anything. I mean, he could have stunned me with the Ice Path, but as soon as I saw the animation, I would have dodged it because I was so close to him. So that's that. We win that team fight. Aegis goes down. I see them with the trap. They see me because they have uphill, and it's not really a big deal. I say that there's a ward there, but there actually isn't. Now that I see the replay, it's just uphill. It's nothing big. They get the invis rune, sadly, so I'm not able to get that. But we're still quite ahead. Let's see this gold. I'm sure we're ahead about by 5,000 or so. Almost 5,000. Yeah. So I was almost there, but we're ahead by about 5,000. It's not huge, but it's something, of course. And here I want to go on this guy, but he has an invis, but of course it does make him blow his invis rune, so he can't gank with it really, because he can gank, but it's going to be a lot less ideal because he has so little health right now. It's about half. So that's going to be that, and we know he uses invis, so the element of surprise is gone. So I'm just going to go back to base because I know I'm not going to wait for the 60 minute rune. Like, I need more mana faster than that. So I'm just gonna go blink bottle, go back to mid, go farm a little bit more. My next item is gonna be crit, so it's gonna be, what's that item before? Well, never mind. So Lina misses the stun again, and I mess up because I cast meld for no reason. I think I thought I casted blink, and so I clicked meld, but I guess I didn't cast blink. So, oh well, two mess ups, it's not really a big deal. Could have been an easy kill, but whatever. So yeah, I'm gonna go crit. I keep forgetting what the names of these items are. I just know that they're crit and Daedalus. Let's see. Shop. Can I click shop? Free cam. Shop. Where's crit? It's Crystalis, right. So I'm gonna go for Crystalis next. And then I'll go for crit, I believe. Or do I go BKB? I think it's I do crit and then I do Crystalis and then I do BKB and then I do Daedalus. I believe that's the order I do it in. When you see this lineup, there's not that much spell damage. Like there's raises and ice path and stuff like that. But it's not like, it's not really like something huge. It's not something that could just instantly kill me. And so I'm not gonna go BKB first. I'm gonna go the more offensive item. Because if I'm able to burst down someone with like a meld crit, then that's gonna really win us the fight, more so than a BKB early on. So that's my rationale behind that. So we go take the tower. Well, we back off first, but in this next push we're gonna take the tower because they use all their big spells. They use their tombstone and stuff like that. So they're gonna go and kill this guy, I hope. Or do they all die? Yeah, this is the part where they all die. And I want to go in, but not really a good idea. But since he has an early mech because he had solo, we are actually able to take this. So I go and I go back in and I do a good amount of damage. He's able to use that stun. I think that was a miss, but it pretty much worked out in our favor simply because of the fact that it burned the trees. So I'm going to go here. He's going to Thunderdome him again. Going to get a meld off. I see that they bought back and I see that they're TPing in. I'm like, let's just go kill them. Let's just go. But they backed off and we could have got that easier. And then I think I didn't even see the glimpse there because I was like, wait, where is he? And then, oh, he's back here. So I go in, I meld. He's able to get that, but we still get him off. The Disruptor gets an ultra kill, which is crazy. And here I'm like, oh, I'm screwed. So I should have went up actually. That would have been better because now I'm helping green out basically, but it doesn't matter. I blink out before the ice pass able to hit and then I get away. So the great thing about blink, so much mobility, especially with Templar Assassin where you already have phase boots. I actually do go BKB first. Man, I'm a pussy. Why would I go BKB first? Oh well, BKB is gonna help. I don't get trapped by anything, I can just move around. But if I think about it right now, crit's actually a better item because I just need the burst to kill somebody because they don't really have spells, really. They would be using spells on like Ursa and stuff as well. Oh well, it's all the same, really. It's not going to make too much of a difference, especially in pubs. In like a more competitive scene, it would matter which item you go first, but BKB is just generally a good item in pubs. Mostly because people don't get it and they don't know how to handle it. So, gonna go. I have 6-1-6 on my kills. My last hits are still really bad. I see that this guy's alone, but not really. Jikiro's here. And so, it doesn't work again. That's one thing you should always be doing as a Templar as well. You should always just be jumping on people. Not so stupid like that. Like, to jump into like 5,000 people and just die. But you should always be pressuring people. If they're alone or if you know they only have two and they can't really kill you, you should just go in. And it's just going to cost you a few bottle charges. Whereas for them, they usually won't have some form of regeneration. Like, they won't have a bottle or a flask ready or some healing spell. Usually they're not going to. So it costs you a few bottle charges, but it puts pressure on them. They get more scared. And they feel less free because they have less health, so they can't move around really. So here I'm like 80 gold away from my speak AB, so I'm just gonna farm these guys really quick. I tell these guys wait for my BKB, but I'm pretty sure they don't listen. I'm pretty sure this is where they just go and die. But that's okay. And so I get my BKB. I wait for it to be delivered because I know the courier is just right there. So I'm gonna farm a little bit more. Nothing much to say, really. One thing I want to say is that Nature's Prophet, I don't know his farm, but I am able to tell in the game that he has really terrible farm for Nature's Prophet. I know I played him a lot. He was one of my heroes that I just played for like a week straight. He's really easy, and if you don't have good farm with him, I don't know what you're doing. So, which one is the item one? Here it is. So, Beastmaster has an Aghanim Scepter already. It's quite good. And Nature's has, yeah, see, he has a Hand of Midas and Shadow Blade at 21 minutes. That's really, really bad, actually. Doesn't even, yeah, he has nothing in the stash either. So, I mean, he's just doing terrible. Like, but right by now, you would want to have, I wouldn't even go for the Shadow Blade, really. I just go for, like, a straight Sheep Stick, simply because of the Ursa and me. Like, if you could sheep one of us, like, when Beastmaster roars, you sheep one of us, like, the roar is gonna mean nothing. And so, you're able to lock us down, able to set up on us, really. So, we go mid. We know we can't push it, so we're just gonna continue to farm. They're playing really defensively, as you can see by their posture on the map. If you see on the mini-map, they're always, like, clustered together. They're always on this side. We have good war coverage, thankfully. The Lina is doing good stuff. But even without it, they're not able to move around at all much because we have control of all the first towers. They only have the top first tower, so they can move around there more often. But not able to do much. And this is something really important. When you have a Nature's Prophet on their team, they get pushed really easily, right? And when you're ahead, like, when you're ahead, the worst thing you could do is trade towers. When you're behind, it's good to trade towers because, you know, you get something out of it. Because when you're behind, you would normally not be able to get any towers because you're behind, you can't move. And so when you trade towers, it's good. But when you're ahead and you have all this map control, you shouldn't be trading towers just because of the fact that you control the map. And you shouldn't be giving them these easy pickoffs, which can allow them to go back into the game. So whenever you see that, just TP in, always have a TP. And yeah, so we defended that. It's not going to do anything. I do that because I know we have a sentry ward. I don't want him to root me or sprout me or whatever. And so I do the BKB. It's kind of a waste, but not really. In the fact that we get the Nature's Prophet, we don't have the split fish fear anymore. And we get an easy kill. So that was quite good. Because we had the sentry ward there, I'm pretty sure he didn't expect that at all. So, that was good. So we go, I wait, I want to kill this Undying, or I wanted to kill the Jakiro. I hope one of them passed by, but of course they don't, because no one wants to play. No one wants to feed me. But I am 6-1, so it's not bad. And keep going, I say we can go mid, but no one wants to go mid, because everyone just wants to farm, but I mean, it's okay, it's whatever. I'll just go and get my crit. We're showing it up. So I go put a trap. And I say Roshan is up, we should go kill him. So I say Ursa, come on. And I think he's gonna get top tower before this. So it's not so bad. Beastmaster gets trapped here. I'm pretty sure he's going to die. Yeah, the Alchemist is gonna wreck him. But it's not before he does all this good stuff. The Lina blinks in, and I was like, what the fuck are you doing? But, so we lose two there for pretty much nothing. We're gonna lose this bottom tower now. I'm just gonna stay around. I'm not gonna jump in at all because that would be my death as well. Even with the BKB, they just have enough right click power just to kill me, really. So, I put a trap up there just for a little bit of vision. But I know we can't do anything, we can only just delay it. So Ursa's gonna clear up top at least. I put a trap behind them just in case. But Ursa's gonna get top and they get bottom. It's still a decent trade for our circumstances, really. So just focus on that sitting, get a few more gold, so I can get my crit up. I know it's 2150. And if you don't know, you can use that trick. You can meld and then hit a catapult, and then it does a lot of damage because catapults have a lot of armor. And so you can just keep doing that. I do it to the normal creep as well, just when I want to finish it off quick. But it does a good amount of damage, and catapults are pretty much, like, guarantees you a last hit. Which is really good, because catapults are worth, like, 80-ish gold, 70-ish gold. So Urza gets a free kill there on Jakiro. I don't really know how, but it doesn't matter, because now I'm like, okay, let me clear this creep wave, and then we're going to go push, or we're going to go Roshan. Get this. I get all my last hits, which you should be doing when you have free farm like that, except for that one. But when you have free farm like that, you should be getting all your last hits. It doesn't matter if it's laning phase or not. Always focus on getting your last hits, because if I just auto-attack there, I probably would have had around 1600 gold instead of 1800 or whatever it was. And I would be a lot farther away from my crit. So, I mean, now it's at the point where I could just farm ancients a little bit, and then I would get my crit. But if I didn't focus on last hitting, I would have missed all of that. So I go, I slow, just so Disruptor can catch up. He's gonna glimpse him back. And there you go. Easy, easy pickoffs. People messaging me on Skype. Shut up. So, I go, say, let's go kill Urza. Okay, I am back. Sorry about that. I had to tell that guy to shut up, because he kept messaging me, and I didn't want the Skype sound to be ruining the video. So, we didn't really miss much. Just go get Roshan. I have a lot of gold now. I have, like, 100 more till my crit. Actually, I already have it, actually. So I go, as you can see, I do a lot of damage. The Alchemist wasn't in his ultimate form, so that's pretty much why. I know he's going to burst down the high HP target, so I go hit the Jakiro, and easy, easy cleanup. Beastmaster is actually really tanky right now, which is why he's able to just go in there and just kill them. I go, kill my Iron Branch, give him a Chrysalis. Now I'm going to be doing a lot of damage. I could almost... If I get a crit off on my meld, I can almost two-shot the Jakiro. I'm pretty sure it'd be three. But yeah, so... I don't have the Aegis this time. It's not Aegis, actually. You know, the actual... A lot of people pronounce it Aegis, but the real pronunciation for, like, the token is Aegis. Like imagine, like, E, and then Jizz. Like, Aegis. That's how the real pronunciation is. So a lot of people get mad when people pronounce it Aegis, but I think it actually sounds a lot better than Aegis, but that's just me. So here's the team fight. Jakiro goes down, Urza goes down, Beastmaster goes down. Urza's not a big deal. Lina gets cut out there. So we're gonna lose this. We got a little bit greedy after getting that tower, but it's not a big deal. So we go, we lose three people for one. I am going to do something really stupid here. So I go meld, and I'm like, okay, I'm gonna blink out of here. And then, nope. He freaking hits me with his freaking rays right there. And so I'm not able to blink because I took damage, and I die. So I could have just stayed there, actually, probably. But he probably would have a cooldown on his rays, and then I would have died anyways. So it's not really a big deal. Yeah, everyone's dying. People would be like, oh, now we're losing the game, blah, blah, blah. But when you play a lot of Dota, you know when you're losing. And I know for a fact that we're not losing this at all. It's just because, I mean, that Alchemist didn't kill that tower in that time he was hitting it. That's how I know we're winning. Because he pretty much had free farm and he's not doing any damage whatsoever. So it doesn't matter if we kill the Alchemist because Glimpse is ridiculous. I go, I see that Shadow Fiend's here, I check his items, I see that it's complete shit, and so I'm really not worried at all now. I use the slow, just to slow him a little bit, because if he had TP or if he had to walk back, it would slow him down when he first arrives, so he's not able to help his teammates so quickly. But he doesn't even have TP, he's just gonna walk there. And so they get that kill clean and easy. So I go, I see that he's there. I mess up, but it doesn't really matter. I'm gonna get all this farm because he refuses to move his treants out of the way. And so I'm gonna get a bunch of extra last hits. Go, bam, more gold, more gold. I mean, it's only 12 gold, but 12 gold is 12 gold. I'll take it any day. Hit that, hit catapult. And now I'm almost at my data list already. Simply because of those, like, two or three waves, really. I think that they're going mid again. I think I tell them to wait here in chat, but I mean, they're not gonna wait. They're just gonna go because they're crazy. Disruptor dies, giving them a mega kill. 503 gold. It's okay. I the only time I would get worried in this game is if they took our mid tower and like one or two of our tier 2 towers, and then I would get worried, because then the presence of the Nature's Prophet is going to become ridiculous because he'll be pushing into our base. But at this time, they don't really have enough towers, and I know they don't have enough farm because that Shadow Fiend is pretty much nothing. So I'm not so worried. So I'm going to farm these. Farm. We don't know where they are. We have wards in their base and at the Ancient. So I do see the Nature's Prophet, but it's not really a big deal. I can't do anything about it. So I'll just leave it be. Go. I tell them I'm going to have my data list soon and that we should smoke. Because if we get a smoke kill on anybody, then it's a free rax for us. Simply because it's exposed. So I'm going to try to get all the lasses I can here. Use the mel trick again on the catapult to secure the kill from the tower. Go and put another trap down on the runes. I haven't been picking up runes a lot, but mostly because we've been moving around and trying to do team fights. So I wait here. It's not going to spawn here, of course, because I have the best luck with runes. It always spawns on the opposite side. But oh well. So I'm going to go. I'm going to get my invis. I'm going to scout them out and be like, okay, now let's go. Let's go kill somebody, please. Here's my invis. And then I know they're there because we just saw them clear out that creep wave. So I'm like, let's just go. Jakiro gets freaked out. He does his thing in a completely wrong way. I focus on that guy because I know he's about to die. I kill the tombstone. I go and I focus down this guy. Luckily, he was able to BKB right then. I thought he was really going to die, which is why I just stayed there. But he activated BKB as soon as the Laguna Blade hit. So that's quite lucky of him, really. Lina possibly could have done that Laguna Blade faster, but I mean, it's all the same. So two of us die, but three of them die, so it's not really a big deal. He stuns him out of the trees, and they're safe. They have a trap there just in case. And they could go for this again, simply because it's 2 versus 3. And if any of them peek their head out, they can go kill them. But they're not going to go do that. Just going to play it safe. Just fine for now, because all we had to do is play it safe for a good, like, 3 to 5 more minutes, and then we'll just go win because of how much farm we have. So Lina actually doing very well for farm. So is the Disruptor. I mean, I guess that's what you get for leaving the Disruptor in the solo lane. When a support gets like a ridiculous amount of farm with mech and pipe and all that stuff, you know something went wrong. Then you got an ultra kill early on in the game. So, yeah. So I see that I have enough gold. I'm going to sell my bottle and I buy all these items. I stack the TPs. Smoke's going to be on the courier. Yep, and then I'm going to go buy my data list and I say go smoke. Smoke is something you should utilize a lot more often in your games. People, especially low levels, I guess they just don't know when to use it. But really, really, as a general thing, if it's past like 30 minutes, you should just be smoking all the time. And trying to go pick off anybody, because if you pick off anybody, they're going to feel a lot more afraid. And then you're just going to be able to wander around the map, go farm, go kill towers, do anything you want. So I'm going to go here. I'm going to say, okay, courier's coming. Let's go smoke. Follow. Put a ward up there, or a trap up there, so I can see if they're moving. I'm pretty sure they don't have a ward here because they've been playing defensively. So I know it's quite safe. So I go, use the smoke. You can use smoke on the courier if you didn't know that. You don't have to transfer it. So we got revealed already, but then they didn't see, or at least they didn't react fast enough. And so we're just gonna march in, we're gonna kill the Shadow Fiend before he can BKB. The Jakiro goes down like nothing. And now we're just free to just go and kill. And I see that they're coming into the traps, and so I trap them really quick. And so I go, trap one, trap two, BKB, they can't do anything, he can't stun me, and he's dead. So now it's, see, I mean, you see how effective that smoke was. You just go and you kill them, and it's great. Kill off the catapult real quick, we just want to push this lane, so pretty much use everything you can to push the lane as fast as you can. Nature's Prophet is pushing bottom because he knows he can't defend, which is smart of him, but I mean, it's still a tier 2 for a Rex, and I'll take that any day. Go here, kill the Rex. Always kill the melee first, if you're wondering, because you have a lot more melee creep than you do range creep in your lane. And so, having them all be tanky is a lot more important than having your range creep do a lot more damage. Kill that, we back off safely. They still have a few seconds to spawn anyway, so we're just gonna clear up their camp a little bit. Radiant's bottom tower seen better days. And I believe we're gonna get top at this point. And now I'm gonna get my Yasha. I'm not so worried about buyback because I know they can't really do anything anyways. Go farm. And yeah, so I'm gonna go get Mantis Dell right now. Or eventually. I'm gonna pick up my Yasha for now. Because the movement speed is actually very important. So I can move around even more. I'm gonna have even more attack speed. More armor. As I'm just gonna be really hard to take down. Through the BKB and all the armor and stuff like that. Go. I believe I go back to base here. Because I see that Destructor's using the carriers, I just want to go get full health and then just go out again. And at this point, if we don't like mess up the next, how many, like 8 team fights, I guess. Yeah, that's funny. But that's if we don't mess up the next like 8 team fights, then we're just gonna win. And even Ursa at this point of the game is still solo killing Jakiro somehow, just because of the Shadow Blade and Jakiro not paying attention or not even getting the right items. Because if you got items such as like Ghost Scepter or Force Staff or something, then he would be able to survive that easy. But I guess he's just too poor right now. What items does he have actually? He has not even a mech, so yeah, he's poor as shit. I'm gonna go, we're gonna kill Roshan yet again. I'm gonna get the cheese and Ursa's gonna get the Aegis, or Aegis, whatever you prefer. And we're gonna go push bottom, because Beastmaster, the smart guy that he is, he knows that we can handle Raj, so he's just been pushing bottom. And even with the Nature's Prophet ultimate, we have too many creep, and so we're just gonna push in. So he gets our top tower again as a trade, but we're gonna go and push bottom, because we don't really care. So by the time Nature's Prophet even teleports back, I believe, we're able to get this tower, which is actually huge. Because the tower is like a huge like component of the team fight. So here we go. I'm gonna go BKB in. Go focus on this tombstone because I know how annoying it is. I'm gonna beat down this alchemist because I'm the only one who can take it without taking so much damage from all his shit. And so I'm gonna go kill him. I see that this guy is here. I know I can go kill him, so I go for it. They glimpse him back, and he's gonna die from the Ursa. And I don't even have to use cheese because I know I'm not gonna die from a half-baked Shadow Fiend ultimate. And so that's pretty much it. We get this Rex, and we pretty much just finish the game. I mean, one thing that I say that Templar Assassins and pubs need to do is just learn who to target. Usually I would target the Jakiro just because he was right there and I know I could burst him instantly. So this is one less person to deal with. Oh, we don't even go for Rex, I believe. I go for Shrines because I'm awesome. But they go for Towers because we could just win anyways. But I mean, one thing that Templar sets need to do when they're fighting, I mean, you see how much damage I do. Like, that meld was, like, seriously, like, 3/4 of his health. But just learning who to target and what's important. And knowing, like at the Alchemist right then, I know I'm the only one who could deal real damage to him. And soak up the charges from his Mjolnir. And he's right there, and he's not moving. And so I don't really have to chase. And so it's just easy damage. But yeah, that's a good game. 40-minute win. 559 GPM. Templar Assassin, not bad. So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know if you want to see more of these. If you want me to do post-commentation or live commentation. Live is going to be a lot more just me talking with my friends. And us just bantering and, like, going as the game goes on. And post is going to be a lot more analysis and seeing, like, oh, this is what I was thinking, or this is what I should be doing, and stuff like that. So let me know what you think. Let me know if you like it. And, yeah, thanks, guys, for watching, and I'll see you next time.